Ladies and gentlemen, will you all please be upstanding for the arrival of the bridal party? Charlie and Donna, may I welcome you here and thank you for coming to share this special day. My name is Liz Folly. I am the Deputy Superintendent Registrar conducting the ceremony today, and I would like to introduce my colleague, Anna Nysaker. It is Anna's important duty to record the official entry in the marriage register. The record of this marriage will be kept at the Beaconsfield Registration Office, where we have handwritten records dating back to 1837. And we're here today to record another historic event as we gather to celebrate the marriage of Charlie and Donna and to witness their vows of matrimony. Marriage joins two people who trust the love that they have found and who wish to share their future together. It is a partnership where they can share their strengths and their weaknesses, their hopes and fears, and is a mutual bond of love, respect, trust, and friendship. It requires devotion, the ability to listen, the wisdom to know when we are wrong, and the strength to put things right. Marriage cannot prevent disappointment, sadness, or grief, but it can bring hope, acceptance, and comfort. Charlie and Donna, today you will exchange vows which will unite you as husband and wife. The words are a formal and public pledge of your love. and a promise of lifelong commitment to each other. But before the ceremony begins, I have to address you all with the following words. This place in which you are now met has been duly sanctioned according to law for the celebration of marriages. You are here today to witness the joining in matrimony of Charles William Bernard Huggins and Donna Marie Cox. If any person here present knows of any reason why this marriage should not be entered into, they should declare it now. Absolute silence, I think we can go ahead. It's the first one. Ladies and gentlemen, the bride and groom have requested two readings as part of their ceremony, and I would like to invite Rebecca and Holly Walker forward, who are going to present the first one on your wedding day.
Today is a day you will always remember, the greatest in anyone's life. You'll start off the day just two people in love and you'll end it as husband and wife.
It's a brand new beginning, the start of a journey with moments to cherish and treasure. And although there'll be times when you both disagree, they will surely be outweighed by pleasure.
You have heard many words of advice in the past when secrets of marriage were spoken. Be near the answers lie hidden inside where the bond of true love lies unbroken.
To live happy forever as lovers and friends, it's the dawn of a new life for you. As you stand there together with love in your eyes from the moment you whisper, I do.
And with luck, all your hopes and your dreams can be real, may success find its way to your hearts.
Tomorrow can bring you the greatest of joy, but today's where the day it all starts.
Thank you, Rebecca and Holly. That was beautifully read, thank you. Can I ask you two to stand? Okay, I'm going to ask you to declare the full names by which you are known today. The groom first, would you please state your full name?
Charles William Bernard Huggins.
And now the bride, would you please state your name?
Donna Marie Cox.
Before you are joined in matrimony, I have to remind you of the solemn and binding character of the vows that you are about to make. Marriage, according to the law of this country, is the union of one man with one woman, voluntarily entered into for life, to the exclusion of all others. I'm going to ask you each in turn to declare that you do not know of any lawful reason why you should not be joined in matrimony to one another here today. Starting with the groom, if you repeat after me. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Charles William Bernard Huggins.
Why I, Charles William Bernard Huggins.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Donna Marie Cox.
To Donna Marie Cox.
And now the bride. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Donna Marie Cox.
Why I, Donna Marie Cox.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Charles William Bernard Huggins.
To Charles William Bernard Huggins.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have now reached the part of the ceremony for the bride and groom to contract their marriage before you, their guests and witnesses. And for this part of the ceremony, I would ask you all to stand as a sign of your support. Who gives this woman to this man?
I do.
Thanks. Let's turn and face each other. Charlie and Donna, you have invited your guests here today to receive their encouragement and support and to celebrate with you at this special time. I ask you now in their presence, Charlie, do you take Donna to be your lawful wedded wife? To be loyal and faithful to her for the rest of your lives together.
I do.
We like eagerness.
Get over.
And Donna, do you take Charlie to be your lawful wedded husband, to be loyal and faithful to him for the rest of your lives together?
I do.
And if you'd like to hold two hands in two now, you're going to say your vows to each other.
All right.
So you'll be looking at each other. And starting with the groom, repeat after me. I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I, Charles William Bernard Huggins.
To witness that I, Charles William Bernard Huggins.
Do take thee, Donna Marie Cox.
To take thee, Donna Marie Cox.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
I promise to support you with love and friendship.
I promise to support you with love and friendship.
I will be your partner and friend for life.
I will be your partner and friend for life.
I promise to care for you.
I promise to care for you.
Remain true to you.
Remain true to you.
And above all, to love and respect you always.
And above all, to love and respect you always.
And now the bride. I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I, Donna Marie Cox.
To witness that I, Donna Marie Cox.
Do take thee, Charles William Bernard Huggins.
To take thee, Charles William Bernard Huggins.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
I promise to support you with love and friendship.
I promise to support you with love and friendship.
I will be your partner and friend for life.
I will be your partner and friend for life.
I promise to care for you.
I promise to care for you.
Remain true to you.
Remain true to you.
And above all, to love and respect you always.
And above all, to love and respect you always.
If I can ask the bride and groom to remain standing, I invite you all to take your seats. Ladies and gentlemen, it is part of a long tradition of marriage in this country that the marriage is sealed with the giving and receiving of a ring. The wedding ring is an unbroken circle, symbolising unending and everlasting love, and is the outward sign of the lifelong promises that Charlie and Donna have made to each other today. And I'd like to invite Darren and Christopher forward, who are going to present the bride's ring. Good, lovely, well done. Thank you. And just hold that onto the knuckle.
This one, yeah?
Yeah. And repeat after me. Donna, I give you this ring as a sign of my love.
Donna, I give you this ring as a sign of my love.
And as a symbol of our marriage.
And as a symbol of our marriage.
And if you'd like to push that into place. Beautiful fit there.
Yes.
And can I ask you to come right round this side now?
That way.
Well done. And if you'd like to present the groom's ring.
Thank you, babe.
Lovely. Do you want to take that? Okay. And repeat after me. Charlie, I give you this ring as a sign of my love.
Charlie, I give you this ring as a sign of my love.
And as a symbol of our marriage.
And as a symbol of our marriage.
And push that firmly into place. I'd like to carry on holding those two hands in two. As you hold hands, these are the hands of your best friend, strong and full of love for you, as you promise to love each other, today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours, as together you build your future. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it, and these are the hands that, even when wrinkled and aged, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. And if I can ask you to take your seats. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to invite Carol Huggins forward, who's going to present the second reading, The Art of Marriage.
A good marriage must be created. In the marriage, the little things are the big things. It is never being too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say, I love you, at least once a day. It is never going to sleep angry. It is having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is standing together and facing the world. It is forming a circle of love and gathers in the whole family. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is not only marrying the right person, it is being the right partner.
Thank you, Carol. That was read with a lot of meaning.
And if you two can stand again and hold hands. A lot of hand holding.
Charlie and Donna, today is the beginning of a new chapter in your life, as you have both made the declarations prescribed by law and have made a solemn and binding contract with each other in the presence of your friends and witnesses gathered here. The vows you have made to each other are a formal and public pledge of your love. Remember what brought you together and concentrate on the good things in your relationship. Support each other through the ups and downs of married life, and the love you have for each other today will deepen and grow stronger throughout the years to come. It is now my great pleasure to announce you are lawfully joined together in matrimony and a husband and wife. May I be the first to congratulate you both and wish you every happiness. And I'm sure your guests won't mind if you give your wife a kiss to seal the occasion. Gentlemen, Anna is now going to bring the register over for the bride and groom to sign. We're not allowed to take any photography or filming at this stage. There's going to be some music for you to sit and enjoy, and we will set up a mock sign for those important photographs after.
Darling dear, love you all the time. I'm just a fool in love with you. Earth angel, the one I adore. Love you forever and ever. Just a fool in love with you. I fell for you, and I knew the vision of your love, loveliness. I hope and I pray that someday I'll be the vision of your half happiness. Oh, oh, earth angel, earth angel, please be mine, my darling dear. Love you all the time. I'm just a fool in love.
I hope and pray that someday that I'll be the vision of your happiness.
Oh, earth angel, please be mine, my darling dear. Love you all the time. I'm just a
presentation to make. wish you a happy Christmas. Celebrations,
maybe? Do my best.
Yes, please. Thank you.
Now, traditionally, that certificate belongs to the bride.
Yeah, thank
you.
Thank
you.
Well,
yeah. Don't
worry about that.
She doesn't have a pocket, does she, in that wonderful gown? So
well, she grabs her money anyway.
Does she?
Yeah.
I assume you're entrusted with that. Well, ladies and gentlemen, the formal ceremonies are now at an end. But for Charlie and Donna, this is just the beginning, as they are about to take their first walk together as husband and wife. I hope that your love and support as family and friends will encircle them, not just for today, but throughout their marriage. Anna and I wish you all a wonderful day as you continue with your celebrations. So now, ladies and gentlemen, will you all please stand? Mr. and Mrs. Huggins will lead you down the road.